I'm Alex Kekesi. I'm the data visualizer with the NASA Goddard Scientific Visualization Studio.
I'm Compton Tucker, and my responsibility in this is interpretation of what's happening on land.
And I'm Gene Feldman. I'm an oceanographer at NASA Goddard, and I'm responsible for everything wet.
And I'm Lauren Ward. I'm a video producer here at Goddard Space Flight Center and will be moderating the conversation. So with that, let's jump right into it. What exactly are we looking at?
What we're looking at is the abundance of plants on land and in the ocean. And in the ocean, we're looking at microscopic plants called phytoplankton. On the land, it's sort of an aggregate of all vegetation. But they breathe, they respire. And they follow the sun in terms of their seasons.
Can you describe the changes that have happened in 20 years since this data set first began?
Yeah, I mean, as crazy it sounds, even though we have 20 years of data, we're still at a point of, in my mind, just the wonder of it. I mean, I can just sit and watch this for hours. And for me, I've got to look at it two different ways. One is just to take a big step back and look at the world as a whole. Don't focus on anything in particular, but just what am I seeing? What are the patterns that I'm seeing? And the main thing is that there's this seasonal cycle moving north and south. The land and the ocean, they both bloom with the rising sun. So if you just step back and watch it, you'll see this wave of green move north and south with the sun.
Back and forth, and you see that so dramatically in this visualization. And Gene and I have been studying this for a long time using satellite data, but what's really cool for us is that you see it for the oceans as well as the land.
Yeah, and which we never saw before the satellites.
Yes.
Is that what makes this vis so special?
What's so critical about this, is the only data set that we have that really shows the biological response to environmental change, okay? We have all these other instruments that measure how the Earth changes, what the temperature, the winds, the currents, rainfall, things like that. We have all of that. But this data set shows what does the Earth's biology do in response to that environmental change.
And I think that's one of the strengths of the SVS, is being able to show that data in a way that a normal average person can really respond to.
And what you've been able to do, Alex, is you make it beautiful.
Yeah, I mean, it is very attractive.
You know, we're looking at the living Earth. We're looking at our home planet change day in and day out. And there's a visceral connection that we have to this home of ours.
Yes. We know there's only one planet we know which has an active biosphere or a biosphere, and that's our planet. We know from the Hubble Space Telescope there are 1 to 2 trillion galaxies in the universe, galaxies. And this is the only planet we know which has life. And it's very special and it's very dear, and this representation to me captures that.
Yeah, I mean, on my part, I mean, really the challenge here was just kind of wrangling all this 20 years worth of data. So, I mean, you guys did an amazing job at collecting it all and creating data sets that can easily be used together. I mean, with the biosphere, it's primarily sea whiffs, aviers, aquamotus?
Yeah. And so you look at this image, and there's so much here that we still don't understand.
I agree with Gene. We're looking at the consequence of instruments on satellites, not looking away from Earth, but looking at Earth through time, how things change, how things vary or don't. It's just fascinating to look at, and it's so dynamic. And this is what's great about time series.
Well, that's one of the thoughts I had, was that the people in this room right now, if you ask yourself the question, what have I done to make sure that the Earth is a healthier and safer place, I think the people in this room can fairly say that they've done quite a lot in collecting the data and then creating the data in a way people can understand it.
What I love about this is there are no country boundaries. There's no distinction between land science and ocean science, or it's one world, one planet, one home. Yeah,
this is our living planet.
Exactly. And the more we, as humans on this planet, inhabitants of the planet, look at this as one entity that we are all responsible for, I think the sooner we will be able to come up with solutions to a lot of the problems that we're facing right now. We have to look at this as one planet where what happens in one place affects what happens in another place.
One planet, one climate, one people, we're all in this together.